Venaani said that the head of state used the event to launch another plan instead of addressing the state of the nation.
The president has only launched a prosperity plan. The president did not tell us how is our economy doing, how is the housing crisis going to be addressed. There is a difference between a state of the nation address and launching a policy, a prosperity document. He could have used the opportunity to launch Harambe and yet to tell us the state of our nation.
The opposition leader also stressed that government should not shy away from being labeled a middle-income country and rather use this tag to maximize opportunities.
I want to advise him, and I will help him as a leader of this country, that we must use the platform of middle-income country. We shouldn't shy away that we are a middle-income country, but we must embed it in our foreign policy, that we start re-engaging the superpowers and financial institutions of the world to make sure that we make them understand that 40% of the world population lives in middle-income countries. We have to renegotiate the terms of engagement with the World Bank, with IMF and all financial institutions. We shouldn't cry about a good status that we are.
Government declared primary and secondary education free, and the education sector received an allocation of over 16 billion Namibian dollars in the 2016-2017 national budget. The official opposition deemed it wise for government to take a different approach towards education.
The official opposition criticized government for focusing on quantity education rather than quality education and blamed this for the state of the country's economy. I'm Adolf Kaure reporting for the News on One.